Hi Internet, recently I was typing, but at night, not only to find out that it was difficult to type late at night, but also rendered my keyboard useless. So I thought, wouldn't it be nice if I have a backlit keyboard? I grasped for my mouse and opened my browser, just to be greeted by disappointment. Such backlit keyboard don't come cheap, and I don't want to throw my old one, so I guess I have to bear with it. Then this idea popped into my head, can we DIY? So without any further ado, let's find out. First things first, familiarize yourself with your keyboard and make the planning, since not all are made the same. After familiarizing myself with the keyboard, I identified the stuff we would need. First, we need a boost converter module, a slide switch, a potentiometer knob, potentiometer, a project case, LED strip, 22 AWD wires, and all the values are in the description. The schematic looks something like this. First, we will get our power from the 5 volts rail of the keyboard and to be followed by the slide switch in series with the boost converter module. Now, the boost converter will boost the 5 volts from the keyboard to a 9 volts, which will light up our LEDs. On the output side, the boost converter module is in series with the potentiometer for dimming and finally the LED strips. Okay, so why 9 volts and not 12 volts? Less voltage just means less current, and less current just means less heat, so less heat means more efficient. And why potentiometer? Isn't that just a variable resistor and there's PWM that's better for dimming? So PWM stands for pulse width modulation, and it looks something like this. As you can see, I'm varying the duty cycle. Let's go to the smallest duty cycle. See? So how do you make a PWM signal? With the help of a 555 timer IC, it will create a PWM signal, vary the duty cycle to dim the LED strip. But one thing, it requires a couple of components, and it is made for high power LED strip dimming, and the LED strip that will be used won't consume such power. So clearly, the potentiometer is the winner chicken dinner. Sorry, I couldn't resist. Like, what is wrong with me? Okay, enough electricity puns. Let's go back to the actual topic. Unplug your keyboard from the computer and unscrew it. Or with the snap of your fingers, let the magic do it. Having a clear look at the keyboard PCB, I have planned my next move. I simply separate the PCB from the entire keyboard and remove the connector attached to it. I then identified that it was a JST connector, so the good thing is it will be easier for me to get power from it. The bad thing is that not all keyboards use a JST connector, so you are at your own. But mostly, you will have to strip the red and black wires. It is just the same procedure. Speaking of wires, most USB devices follow the USB color coding, red for 5 volts and black for ground, and the other 2 to 3 wires are for data. Usually, there will be 4 wires, but some are 5, like this one over here. There are 2 black wires. It is okay to strip any of those black wires because they are just boot ground wires. I used my soldering iron to strip the wires by melting the insulation, as shown as in the video. After stripping the wires, I performed a Y-splice on the newly stripped wires, and then I soldered it afterward. I also added electrical tape for insulation to prevent short circuits. With the wires already soldered, it is advised to power the module from a USB port, and using a multimeter, it should read somewhere around 5 volts. After getting a measurement, I put everything back together and screwed a few screws back. Make sure you have already made the hole on the keyboard. It is up to you where you will run the wires. Sorry, I forgot to show that I set the boost converter to 9 volts. Read the instructables below on how to. Afterwards, make markings on the plastic box so you would know where to put the components. Now, just keep making holes. I use screw and screwdriver for this and it works. I don't have a drill to do the job, so you can also do the same. And using scissors, I carve the holes. And with a little bit of force, I was able to place the potentiometer. Switch. I did the same method but in a rectangular manner. Side, it wounded my finger. With all the components in place, you can now begin soldering it one by one. With the project box being too small, it was a hard time soldering the components. I recommend using a tweezers for this project. Okay, now we are done soldering. Test the circuits by connecting the LED strip on the output wires. And happily run the wires. Remove the keys from the numpad row. And clean it up first. Using screwdriver and screw, do the same method in making holes. After running the wires, I splice them according to their color coding. Be mindful of the polarity or else it won't light up. Now, cut 3 to 4 centimeters of wire and just wire the strips. Keep repeating the same process for the rest. Use screwdriver and screw again to make the holes and just do the same. Thank you. Same on the last part, I won't be adding the LED strips on the F1 to F12 Pro because it's redundant. Now, I use glue gun to conjoin the box and the keyboard. Before anything else, test the keyboard backlighting. Your PC might lag or won't function well. That is because Windows is still not ready for allowing such current on its USB port. If I were you, I would plug the keyboard on a USB 3 port. But if it didn't lag or still function the same, then you don't need to deal with the power settings. But if it does, follow the next step. What I am doing here is I am altering the Windows power settings. So if you are on a Mac or any other OS out there, you are on your own. Make sure to follow every single thing I do here to achieve the expected results. So for those of you who didn't experience lag when a keyboard light is on, fast forward to now there, everything is set. You can now open the keyboard. Although one problem, you still can't see the keys. I assume your keyboard is under something. So using an aluminum tape, add it above the keyboard like this. Just keep adding more until it reflects back to the keys. And there, voila, a backlit keyboard. Now, see the difference for yourself. And there you have it. Thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe and watch me next time.